are set to bring you baseball from one of the crown jewels of the sport, venerable Wrigley Field in Chicago. Tonight, it's a matchup from the NL Central between the Cincinnati Reds and the Chicago Cubs. The Reds are riding an 8-game win streak. They'll try to run it to 9 next. Jose Quintana is on the mound for the Cubs in this one. Dan Plesac, what's the word on him?
Hey, you can't always judge a pitcher by the numbers. I know the ERA is into the fours coming into this start, but he's actually a pretty solid pitcher. And every once in a while, he can throw some decent games in there. It's not easy having an ERA under four in baseball. He's slightly over that, but this guy's a better pitcher than that ERA indicates.
So striding in, Jose Reyes. He'll get us started in this one under the lights. A called strike to the 35-year-old veteran. Nothing in one. But guys, as we look at the Cubs coming into play here tonight, they come in playing reasonably well of late, though they have dropped their last two in a row.
Hey, thanks, Matt. You know what, Dior? You got to give this team a lot of credit. They're on the outside looking in on the postseason picture, but boy, they're playing out the string and they're playing out well. They're going to play this thing all the way to the end of the season.
You know, Dan, I can't speak for the pitcher side of it, but I have never been on a team, win, lose, or draw, whether I was going to the postseason or not, that had players that gave away at bats. You just will not see it at this level. The mark of a great pitcher is the ability to put people away when you have two strikes on them. He wasn't able to do it to start the game. Let's see if he makes the adjustment.
Here's a look over to first. And here's Jose Peraza. Bunt attempt is popped into foul ground. Reyes on at first, nobody out. And a good call as they pitch out there, but Reyes isn't going yet. Quintana sets. 0-2 pitch on its way. Fouled away. The 0-2 once more. Line towards center field. In there, a base hit.
Hey, after that base knock right there, he's in the double digits, D-Row. That's a 10-game hitting streak.
Oh, you talking about double digits, Dan? Now it's getting firm. We're seeing the batting average go up. We're seeing the homers go up. We're seeing the RBIs go up. Everything is moving north.
Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Hard hit ball to second. Zobrist has it. There's one on to first, and Kemp is bounced into a double play. And a moment now to glance at the Reds lineup card in this one. Dan, who do we keep an eye on?
Yeah, Matty, you've got to keep an eye on Yasiel Puig. I really enjoy watching this guy hit, and he's leading the National League in batting average right now. No doubt that he's one of the best hitters in the game today, and I hope to see him show us what he can do in this one.
First pitch on its way, and he gets a piece here as this ball is fouled away.
Great job by everyone involved right there. Executed a great pitch, got the double play, but don't kid yourself, there's still a guy standing on third base. He still needs one more out.
A 1-1 count to Puig. So let's take a peek at the umpiring crew in this one. Behind the plate is Ricky Holiday.
Yeah, Dan, we got Ricky Holiday behind the dish tonight. I can't figure his zone out. He doesn't favor the hitter or the pitcher and can be a little too inconsistent at times.
D-Row, you hit the nail right on the head. I think one of the things we're looking for a consistent zone. If it's a tight zone, it's a high zone. Have the same zone. His zone fluctuates a little bit too much for my liking during the course of a game.
2-1, here it is. Line towards center field. Almora is there, and he puts this one away for the third out. So a great job there of working out a potential trouble. So they're able to get the runner to third in the opening half inning, but can't bring him around. Now the Cubbies will get their first crack. No score. Anthony DeSclafani will do the pitching in game three of the series. Dan Plesac, what do you got?
This guy here is one of the top strikeout pitchers in all of baseball. Over 200 strikeouts in the season. And this day and age where we don't see pitchers go that deep into games and pitch well over 200 innings, that's saying something. If this guy is on, it could be lights out and lots of K's.
That's in there. And he's deep in the hole now, 0-2.
He's had to be sitting out over that outer half of the plate. For him to take those first two pitches right there, finds himself 0-2, I'll be surprised if the pitcher doesn't go right back to that spot.
Ready with another 0-2. Popped him up. Farmer is under it. One out. And a chance now from the north side of Chicago to check out the Cubs starting lineup. Anybody catch your eye, Dan?
Well, Matty, the guy I'm here to see is Big Chris Bryant. He's on a nice stretch. That's three home runs in his last 10 games. He's swinging the bat really well right now. And by watching his mannerisms in the box, he just looks comfortable in the plate. He's in some kind of a groove.
The windup and the 0-1. Another one fouled off, and he's quickly behind 0-2. One out, nobody on. Can't quite get around in time to keep it fair, and it remains 0-2. The bouncer to the left side. Throw gets him, two down.
Batting third, the third baseman.
Stepping into the box, Chris Bryant. He'll get to take his first cuts here. In there at the knees, strike one. Bryant makes a lot of great contact against left-handed pitching, perhaps one of the best in the game in that regard, but he does have his warts against right-handers at times. Just not as proficient at putting the ball in play when it's coming from that side.
This is why this guy is so effective. He's able to pound the zone, get ahead in the count, and now he has so many options to go to. I really can't.
And we'll have to leave it there as the play is made here to end the inning. Cubs are down in order. We are still scoreless. Next up will be Kyle Farmer. He's back in the starting lineup for this one after sitting out last night's game. First offering on its way. Lofted in the air out to right field. On the move is Hayward. He's there and records the first down.
So here's how the Chicago Cubs are positioned defensively. And guys, the thing I want you to take a look at today is in today's game, the new age, everyone wants to move around. This manager does not like to shift a lot. Maybe a step to your right or left, but there's a lot of trust that the pitchers are going to execute. So let's see how it works out for them in this one.
In is Joey Votto now. He's had a real nice season in the batting average department, but he'll need to turn it on a bit down the stretch if he wants a chance at claiming that coveted batting title. Curveball just misses, apparently, 1-0. A 1-1 count to the Reds' first baseman. The 1-1. And now a swing here by Votto as this is sent on the ground out to short. On to first, and Votto's gone for out number two.
Batting seven, the center fielder, Scott Scheffler.
And that brings up Scott Scheffler. In past meetings with Jose Quintana, batting at an even 400. He's taken him deep once. Strike one to start the at bat. Scheffler stands at 6 foot even. Bats left, throws right. He was taken in the 26th round back in the 2010 first year player draft.
I know this guy wouldn't go into the category of superstar, but to grind out the career he has being drafted where he was, my hat's off to him.
Set to deliver on nothing and two. Here it comes. Swing and a miss, and that ends the inning. Reds are down in order. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. Ready now, Javier Baez, looking to stay hot. He's been a real threat at the plate the last week or so. Swung on and missed for the first strike.
You know, on a cold night like this, I think you're going to see him continue to elevate pitches and let these guys just fly out to the warning track.
And it's fouled away. Into center field, line drive base hit. With that, the Cubs get their leadoff man aboard. Into the box, Anthony Rizzo. First pitch on its way. And he begins the at-bat with a knuckle curve looked at for strike one. Baez gets his lead at first, nobody out. Swing and a little blooper to center. And that's in there, base hit.
Hey, two runners on after back-to-back singles right there. They are in prime position to put the first run on the board right here.
Here's the young catcher, Wilson Contreras. First chance for him here after appearing as a pinch hitter in the game last night. Now time is called, and this could very well be to buy a few more pitches for those relievers. From the stretch. Now a swing and a miss at a slider for a strike. So far this season, with runners in scoring position, Contreras brings a batting line of barely over 200, so there's certainly some room for improvement there.
Yeah, Matty, he's well aware of it. Runners in scoring.
Oh, and it eats him up a bit. And a great job to stick with it here as he gets the first out of the inning. On to first, but not in time as he beats it out.
The right fielder, Jake Dad.
So one out here with runners at first and third. And that'll bring up the multi-gold glover, Jason Hayward. Here's the first pitch to him. Lifted the other way out to left center. Schebler sprinting after it. He can't get to it. This one's down. But now a throw from the outfield will get him. How slow can you be? And he will score on the sacrifice fly as he's in with our first tally of the ball game.
Oh, man, I don't know how that happened. Looked to be a base hit to the outfield, but then all of a sudden the throw comes in and they get the force on the play. To be honest, that just can't happen.
Standing in now, Jose Quintana. As he'll take a look at a slider here that finds the zone for strike one. Big swing and a miss at the fastball, and he's behind in the count 0-2.
Hey, make a pitch right here and get out of this. Get the boys in the dugout and regroup.
And the second baseman is there to make the play, and that. Leading off the inning, Juan Castilla, and they'll need him to get something going here. Quintana into the windup. Here's the first pitch. And he lays off a pitch in there for the first strike. Castilla, a native of the Dominican Republic. This is his first year at the big league level. Line to the right side. Hayward is there to put it away for out number one.
Batting nine.
So here now is the pitcher, Anthony DeSclafani. Cody Sullivan will get the call here as he'll hit for the pitcher.
Hitting for the Red. Number 15, Cody Sullivan.
Now a fastball is lifted into the air to shallow center. Hayward giving chase. He's got it. A nice play there. Two away. In now for the Reds, Jose Reyes. Two away in the inning, and Dan, it looks like this could be another 1-2-3 inning for him.
Yeah, he has really found a groove on the mound, and it's been impressive to watch.
And we'll have to leave.